we're going to use three different types of visual indicators. We'll use a hand every time I tap. Every time I hit a button on the outside of the device, we'll give you an icon, and we'll use arrows to help point out key information on screen. Let's start with setting up guided access. Tap on the Settings app, tap on the General tab. On the General tab, scroll up or down to find Accessibility. Tap on Accessibility. Using your finger, scroll up or down to find Guided Access. Under General Accessibility Guided Access, you will be able to turn Guided Access on. So to turn it on, I touch the on-off slider, and two settings appear. First is Set Passcode. Now, when I was first experimenting with this, it wasn't apparent that you had to set a passcode. So what I'm telling you is you have to set a passcode, otherwise you're going to go through the same problem that I went through. So setting a passcode is really easy. Tap on Set Passcode. It's going to give you a 4-digit number to put in. I'm going to, for the sake of this demo, pick a very easy one. I would recommend for you to pick something more complex. But for this demo, there we go. I've now set my passcode and confirmed it. The other thing is, the iPad assumes that when you are in guided access mode, that you are facilitating this with someone else for someone else's usage, and you want the application to be on all the time. If you're in a teaching environment, as an example, and you want the iPad to turn off even when you're staying in that application, then you would enable screen sleep. But by default, it's not enabled. For more information, go to iPadsForSpecialNeedsBook.com, where you'll find more videos, other resources like cheat sheets, and a book on how to use the iPad for your special needs user.